In this segment, we'll be talking about how to obtain a developer key to make YouTube API calls and run the sample code. To do this, we'll need a registered Google account. The first thing we want to do is browse at a Google API console. We can find this at code.google.com/APIs/console. Or we can just search for Google API console in our favorite search engine. We'll need to create a project the first time we open the site. Projects are a grouping of APIs, and it may make sense for us to create different projects for every new application that we write. For running the sample code, we only need one project and one set of API keys. After we enable our project, we'll need to enable some services. Let's click through to the Services menu if we're not already on this page, and scroll down. We'll want to enable the YouTube Data API and the YouTube Analytics API first. Let's toggle the YouTube Data API from off to on. The very first time we do this, we'll be presented with the Terms of Service. We want to read Terms of Service and accept if we want to be able to use the API. Now when we scroll down, we'll see that the YouTube Data API has been accepted and enabled. We'll click on to also enable the YouTube Analytics API. The Search by Topic code sample requires the use of the Freebase API, so we need to enable that as well. There's a separate Terms of Service that we'll need to read and accept. Once this is done, we'll need to access our API keys. We can do this by clicking API Access in the navigation menu. There are two types of API access, simple and authorized. If all we want to do is search for videos, channels, and playlists, all we need is simple API access. The key is already provided to us in our project.